Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to display aggregate values for columns in the React TreeGrid component. An aggregate is a special row that shows processed results of other rows. I can perform a set of arithmetic calculations on specific TreeGrid column and display those values either in the TreeGrid footer or in the child footer. I'm sure you have watched my previous video on how to get started with a React TreeGrid. If not, please watch the video linked in the card above or from the description below. I begin by opening the same application where all the necessary TreeGrid modules are configured. Note that the datasource.js file has local JSON data with the task and subtask details and is bound to the datasource property. And the subtask details are configured to the parent records using the child mapping property. I have mapped a few columns from the data source to be displayed in the tree grid using the columns directive. Let me run this application now. As you can see, the tree grid is rendered with the local JSON data. Now I'll remove the paging related codes for better understanding of aggregate feature. To enable aggregates, I import the aggregate module and inject it into the tree grid component. First, I'll show you the built-in aggregate types available in the TreeGrid component. Sum, average, min, max, count, true count, and false count. Here, I'm going to show you the sum aggregate value in the duration column. I include the aggregates directive to define one or more aggregate rows in the TreeGrid component. Since I'm going to define one row, I include one aggregate directive. Then I include aggregate columns directive to add one or more aggregate columns. Since I'm going to show one aggregate column, I include one aggregate column directive tag. The two mandatory properties required to show aggregate columns are field and type. To perform aggregation on duration column, I specify the field as duration. Then using the column name property, I define the column name to show the aggregate value. And I specify the aggregate type for this column using the type property and assign it to sum. I need to specify the template to be displayed in the footer by using the footer template property. I create a callback function and display the sum value using the props variable. Here you can see aggregate rows are shown for each parent in the TreeGrid hierarchy. The aggregate row at the bottom of the tree grid displays the sum of the duration column values for all the tree grid rows. By default, child summary values are shown while adding aggregates. So to avoid this, I include the show child summary property in aggregate directive and set its value to false. See the tree grid now. Child summary is disabled and only one aggregate row is shown in the tree grid footer. Next, I'll show you how to add a custom aggregate in the TreeGrid component. Here, in this example, I'm going to show the count of records that have high priority using the custom aggregate property. So I include another aggregate column using the aggregate column directive tag. I specify the field and column name as priority. Since I'm going to use my own aggregate function, I specify the type as custom. Then I include the footer template property and specify the caption as high priority count. Then I access the custom value inside the template using the custom key from the props variable. Then I include the custom aggregate property and assign the callback function custom aggregate function. Inside this function, I use get object method from the EJ2Grids package and get the sample data to process. Then I define the variable count length and initialize it to 0. I filter each record and get the priority field value by passing the field name as priority along with the record details in get object method. Then I will update the count length variable based on the match and return the count. Check the tree grid. The high priority count has been displayed for the priority column. If I want to display it in a separate TreeGrid footer row, I simply add another row using the aggregate directive tag and paste this column inside that tag. I also disable the Show Child Summary property. Notice here, the custom aggregate is shown in the separate footer row. Here is a quick recap of what we have seen so far. I showed you how to display built-in and custom aggregates in the TreeGrid component using the footer template property. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you are eligible for our community license, which will provide you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.